हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू मीट साइंस क्लास। टुडेज टॉपिक इज मीट क्वालिटी पार्ट टू, दैट इज माइक्रोबियल क्वालिटी ऑफ मीट। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मीट क्वालिटी वन, इन व्हिच आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फिजिको केमिकल क्वालिटी एंड द न्यूट्रिशनल क्वालिटी। Today we are going to discuss about microbial quality, which includes spoilage of meat. In the next topic, we are going to discuss major aspects of this meat science course, that is meat preservation and then meat processing. Before going for it, we should know the basic aspects of microbial quality and spoilage of meat. So as we have already told earlier, meat is highly perishable. That means it spoils very easily because of its quality of nutrition and other characteristics. Therefore, it needs very special care and handling from the point of slaughter till the consumption of meat as a food. And another important aspect here about meat is it is very easily contaminated because it is originating from the animal and animal itself is very dirty. So it is the main source of contamination for all kind of microorganisms. Therefore, we need very special care, which we have mainly discussed in the unit 3 in abattoir and meat hygiene. Now these organisms, different kind of organisms which comes from the animal and enter into the meat, their growth and multiplication causes lot of deteriorative changes and thereby it reduces the quality of meat or leading to the spoilage of meat. Unless we take proper care, meat will be deteriorated and its quality will go down. Now, as I already said this in previous unit in abattoir and meat hygiene, the major sources of contamination for the meat is the animal itself, mainly its hide and skin, which is full of microorganism, and somehow it can enter into the meat, and particularly if the handling is not proper, then the GI tract, gastrointestinal tract, is having millions and millions of microorganisms. So if there is any mistake in processing, handling, evisceration, then there will be contamination. Then different kind of instruments which are used for the slaughter process, that also are the source of contamination. Water we use, it has to be very good quality, otherwise it can cause contamination to the carcass or from the instruments which are used for washing. Then airborne contamination. So from the outside air, the microbes can come and it can contaminate, for which proper measures are there in the slaughterhouse hygiene we have discussed. And the hands and clothing of the working personnel. So working personnel, their personal hygiene practice should be very good. Otherwise, they will be the source of contamination for the carcass and their clothes. Now, what are the types of organisms which may be there in meat? So most important type of microorganisms are bacteria and the others are fungi. So bacteria you all know very much what is that, and the fungi, they are the multicellular filaments which are called molds, or sometimes they may be large single cells with buds. They are called the yeast. Now molds are capable of producing minute spores under unfavorable condition. When the meat is kept with proper preservation and other protection, that time molds can produce minute spores and can cause deterioration of meat. Now here is the most common bacteria found in meat, particularly responsible for spoilage of meat. So they are, as you all know, gram-positive and gram-negative organism. In gram-positive, most common bacteria are Micrococcus, Staphylococcus, maybe Staphylococcus aureus, Streptococcus, different species, Lactobacillus species, Leuconostus, Bacillus cereus, then Clostridium perfringens, Clostridium nigrificans, Corynebacterium species, Mycobacterium species. These are the common microorganisms responsible for spoilage of meat. And the gram-negative organism like Pseudomonas, these are very common spoilage organism, Flavobacterium, Acinobacter, Acromobacter, Alkaligenes, Halobacterium, Moraxella, Escherichia and Klebsiella. All these are gram-negative and commonly responsible for spoilage of meat. Now, this is again a very basic aspect. You might have already studied in basic microbiology, that is bacterial growth. It has got few phases like lag phase, log phase or logarithmic phase, stationary phase and death phase. So lag phase means there won't be much multiplication, only increase in size. Log phase means there will be very fast growth, logarithmic phase. Stationary phase means again the growth will be very constant. And the death phase is where the bacterial cell will be destroyed, either environmental cause or preservation or due to nutritional deficiencies. Now for the bacterial growth, there are some factors which controls their growth and thereby indirectly it has a relevance to the spoilage of meat. So basically they are classified into two categories: intrinsic factors and extrinsic factors. Intrinsic factors means the factors which is within the food, in this case meat, that is water activity, nutrient, pH and redox potential. And the extrinsic factors means that is the outside the meat, the factors outside the meat, that is temperature, oxygen and relative humidity. We are briefly going to discuss these factors. So first is intrinsic factors, in which first one is the water activity. So what is water activity? It is indirectly reflecting the amount of water present for the growth of microbes. So this is actually having a definition like it is the ratio of vapor pressure of water in the food and the ratio of vapor pressure of the pure water. So this is expressed as water activity. And it has a direct relation with the microbial growth and multiplication. Normally in fresh meat, the water activity will be 0.99 or above. Now in case of bacterial growth, they can grow at a water activity of 0.91, up to 0.91, not below that. Whereas in case of yeast and mold, they can grow up to 0.86. That means, if we want to prevent all microbial growth, the water activity should be 0.86 and below. In other words, the level of water content in the meat or meat food should be reduced, then only we can achieve this low level of water activity. That is almost semi-dried type of meat. Otherwise, any kind of microorganism can grow. So meat is very ideal for microbial growth because of the high water content. And next is nutrient. So nutrient is very important for microbial growth. And as you already know, meat is rich in all the nutrients. First is water is very ad libitum, and the presence of very good quality protein, fat, little bit of carbohydrate and other minerals and vitamins are also present. So these are most ideal nutrient for microbial growth, and that is why it is very good for microbial multiplication. Then there is, in the intrinsic factor, there is pH. pH is very important for microbial growth. Most of the microorganism, their ideal pH is at the neutral zone. Neutral pH, that is around 7. So 7 plus minus 0.5 or plus minus 1. At this range, most of the microorganism is favorable for growth. So in case of meat, as I have said earlier, during conversion of muscle to meat, the pH goes down due to the postmortem anaerobic glycolysis. The pH goes down up to 5.5, which we call ultimate pH. And this is a very good factor for preventing the microbial growth. It prevents the growth of most of the microorganism or reduces it. And the last factor under intrinsic factors is the redox potential. So this is a status of the meat. So meat is in what state? That is in reduced state or oxidized state. So this state influences the growth of microorganism. Now there is extrinsic factors. Extrinsic factors means the factors outside the meat. So most important is temperature. As you all know, the temperature is very important for microbial growth, and the microbes are classified into three categories based on their optimum temperature for growth. So there is psychrophils, which grow below 20 degree, preferably around 10 to 15 degree. They are called psychrophils. Then there are thermophils, which grow above 45 degree Celsius, and there is mesophils, which are in between, that is 20 to 45 degree Celsius. Now mostly we keep the meat at low temperature, in case of refrigeration around 5 degree Celsius. So this prevents the growth of mesophils and thermophils, but it can only slightly reduce the growth of psychrophils. So psychrophils still can grow and cause spoilage. So most of the bacteria which comes under this category, like Pseudomonas, Acromobacter, Flavobacterium, Micrococcus, Streptococcus, they cause spoilage of meat, even in case of vacuum packed meat, which we will be discussing later on. Now other extrinsic factors like oxygen. So there should be available oxygen. Many microbes can grow only when oxygens are available. So they are called aerobic microbes. So availability of oxygen determines the growth of microbe. Bacteria that grow in surface of meat, they are aerobes. So there are some bacteria which are aerobic. They grow on the surface and cause aerobic spoilage. But most of the yeast and mold, they are basically aerobic. So they grow on the surface and cause the spoilage. And the another last factor is relative humidity. So relative humidity is about the availability of moisture around the food. So this is also an important extrinsic factor which helps in microbial growth. So meat undergoes surface spoilage from certain bacteria, yeast and molds when the relative humidity, that is the surrounding moisture level, is high. That can cause the spoilage by the bacteria, yeast or mold. Now what happens during spoilage, we want to briefly discuss. In general, what happens, when the bacterial population start growing and it increases in number, and when it reaches 10 to the power 7, then there is the signs of spoilage appear. Different kind of changes or symptoms of spoilage will appear when the microbial load goes beyond 10 power 7 per gram, or we say 7 log per gram. Now at this stage, what will happen? There will be various types of off odors or smells and changes in tastes due to the deterioration or due to the changes by the microbial growth. This may lead to surface color change. Various surface color will come, or due to the pigment from bacteria. Similarly, fungus can grow when the meat is having less moisture. So when we have some kind of semi-dried meat, that time bacteria cannot grow. So that time fungus will start growing. These are the general aspect for spoilage. Molds can grow on semi-dried meat and cause surface stickiness. And also sometime whiskers it is called. Now spoilage we can discuss in two category. One is aerobic spoilage, another is anaerobic spoilage. So aerobic spoilage means when there is air available or when there is oxygen available. That time some specific bacteria and yeast will grow and causes the spoilage. So first sign of aerobic spoilage is slime formation on the surface. Due to the growth of the bacteria, there will be colony formation and their coalescence lead to the sliminess. So that is the characteristic of aerobic spoilage. This also may lead to discoloration of meat due to oxidizing agent. So due to the growth of microbes, they will produce the metabolites that causes oxidizing effect and causes discoloration of meat due to the effect on the meat pigment or myoglobin. Similarly, aerobic spoilage can cause production of off odors, that is very common, And it also can cause proteolysis and lipolysis. Due to the growth of microbes, that will produce the proteolytic enzymes and lipolytic enzymes. And because of that, there will be breakdown of proteins and lipids, and there will be undesirable changes. There will be little bit of carbohydrate, if at all it is available, that will break down and form the indole and skatol. Now here is the specific changes during aerobic spoilage. First one is by the bacteria, spoilage by bacteria. So there will be surface slime formation, mainly due to Pseudomonas, Acinetobacter, Alkaligenes, Streptococcus, Leuconostus and Micrococcus. There will be oxidation of fat and leading to tallowish smell or flavor of fat. Sometime that may cause also rancidity. And another way of rancidity is due to the lipolytic bacteria. Some bacteria, they produce large amount of lipolytic enzyme which cause breakdown of lipids and leading to rancidity, like Pseudomonas and Acromobacter. Spoilage by yeast, mainly it causes sliminess, lipolysis and off order and taste. It will cause these common changes and sometime discoloration, like white color or cream color or pink color or brown color. Then spoilage by molds. Here stickiness can happen, decomposition of fat can happen, leading to off orders. Sometime there will be musty flavor and there will be color changes. So what are the color changes in meat due to the aerobic spoilage? Aerobic spoilage due to the bacteria, there can be red spot by Serratia marcescens, blue color by Pseudomonas cinciana, yellow color by Micrococcus and Flavobacterium, and greenish blue color by the Chromobacterium. Similarly, there can be color changes due to fungal spoilage, like whiskers, that is caused by Thamnidium, Mucor and Rhizopus. Black spot caused by Cladosporium harbarum, white spot by Sporotrichum carnis, and another one, that is green patches due to the Penicillium species. Now there is anaerobic spoilage. Anaerobic spoilage means when there is no air available or no oxygen available. There are a lot of organisms, particularly bacteria, which grow in anaerobic conditions. So under anaerobic condition, meat decomposition is more offensive, more foul smelling. There will be putrefaction in the deep tissues or in the deep joints of bone. So that causes foul smell and taints. So sometimes we call it bone taint. That is, deep inside the carcass, joint will remain hot for a long time due to improper chilling, leading to this anaerobic spoilage and foul smell. There may be souring also due to the accumulation of organic acids in anaerobic fermentation. So anaerobic spoilage, again there can be souring, as I said, sour odor and taste due to the fatty acids, that is formic acid, acetic acid, butyric acid, propionic acid or other organic acid like lactic acid and succinic acid. So this happens due to the breakdown of fat in the anaerobic spoilage. There will be putrefaction. Putrefaction means it is about the decomposition of protein, and there will be foul smelling compounds like hydrogen sulfide, very bad smell, mercaptans, very bad smell, and ammonia and amine. So these are caused by most commonly proteas, very important for proteolytic changes or putrefaction. Then there is Clostridium, Pseudomonas, Alkaligenes. And there is sometime taint formation, that is off order and taste, by souring or putrefaction next to the bones. As I said, in case of heavy carcass, if the chilling is slow, the deep inside the joint, the temperature remains high for a long time, leading to anaerobic spoilage and sometime commonly called as bone taint, mostly caused by enterococci. Now we are at the last part, that is about the detection of meat spoilage. So meat spoilage can be detected based on the changes caused by different microorganisms or their enzymes, or we can detect by the indirectly by counting the microbial numbers. So during spoilage, different kind of microbes or bacteria or yeast, they grow and make lot of changes, particularly due to their growth, there will be a lot of metabolites produced, and that leads to the all undesirable effect. So we can measure these different metabolites, and then we can estimate the spoilage. So thus meat spoilage can be detected by physical methods or chemical methods, or sometimes we call physicochemical methods, and also through microbial methods. So physicochemical method, basically we can observe the physical changes like discoloration, slime formation, stickiness, whiskers. There is a test called rhizargyrin reduction test, like which is used in case of milk. So here when the spoilage is very high, the reduction will be very fast within 2 hours, and there is a good correlation with the microbial count or bacterial count and rhizargyrin test timing. Then there is ammonia, indole, scatol, methylamine, hydrogen sulfide, mercaptans. These are the metabolites produced by microbial growth. So we can measure the quantity of these chemicals, and we can come to a conclusion about the status of spoilage. There is further physicochemical methods like incipient spoilage in meat. It can cause rise in pH, water holding capacity, and of course bacterial count in meat. At the time of incipient spoilage, pH value will be more than 6.5, and many times it can reach up to 8.5. When meat get putrefied, then the value of pH can rise even up to 8.5. Then there is another parameter called extract release volume. So this is about testing the how much extract the meat will release. So when the meat is badly spoiled, it will have very high water holding capacity, so release of extract will be reduced very badly when it is very badly spoiled. Similarly, there are other methods like TBA, thiobarbituric acid value, and tyrosine value. TBA is pertaining to oxidation of lipid. When there is oxidation and acidity, this product will be produced, thiobarbituric acid. So from that we can say it is oxidized. Similarly, tyrosine value is related to protein breakdown or proteolysis. So when there is too much of protein breakdown, we can measure the level of tyrosine, and we can tell about the status of the meat or freshness of meat. So finally, we have microbial method. So here what we do is we test the level of microbes like total viable counts. So we can enumerate the total microbes like mesophils, hygrophils, and measure their freshness. It indicates the handling and freshness of meat. Similarly, coliforms like E. coli and Aerobacter aerogenis, so their presence indicate the unhygienic handling, processing, or fecal contamination. There is enterococci like fecal streptococci. Their presence indicate poor hygienic quality of meat and meat products. And lastly, there is other indicators like Staphylococcus, Salmonella, yeast and mold. Those are also important indicators. So these are briefly, I have discussed different aspect of microbial quality of meat, their source, contamination, type of microbes, and how to estimate what changes it happens. Thank you. I will come back with the next lecture again, maybe on the preservation of meat. Thank you.